There are a lot of campaign settings out there for Dungeons & Dragons and various fantasy-based role-playing games, but today I wanted to talk about one that I found very intriguing. This is Settlers of a Dead God, where you play insects on some kind of humanoid corpse that is basically sustaining life through decomposition. Everybody, Jordan here, the PH is silent. Welcome to the Jocular Junction. Today I'm going to talk about Settlers of a Dead God. This is for Old School Essentials and is not paid for, but I did receive this book for free from the creator. So I have some of my Old School Essentials out here just because this is an Old School Essentials game designed for use with Old School Essentials. This is written by Eduardo Carabano. I hope I pronounced your name correctly. I apologize if I do not. So the basis for this is that we the players, live on a dead god that is decomposing. And we don't really talk about what's outside of the dead god. It's kind of like living on the planet, and in your adventures, you don't really need to know what's on the outside of the planet. But everyone in this game is an insect. So you're going to run into various types of insects, and there are colonies, and there are insect hotels, there are taverns, there are all kinds of crazy things on the dead god, and you're going to go through various hazards by going up and down and left and right and all over. It does a really good job of transitioning items from Old School Essentials, items from like original Dungeons and Dragons, and converting it into something that is relatable to this campaign setting. So skin is used for clothes and footwear and decorations. Hair is used for like rope and stuff. It shows, you know, there are materials like metal, stone, but those are going to be bone, calcifications, things like that. And then there's all these different kinds of territories that they've split up the dead god, this humanoid creature that you're living on. So there's the head, the torso, the extremities, which are like the east and west arms and legs and stuff. And below the torso, if I'm remembering correctly, you don't go like extremely far. So there is like an uncharted area. And then there's also like what's down below and inside the body. And inside the body is where you're going, inside the dead god, I should say, is where you're going to find the best rewards, and that coincides with dungeon delving. There is no official who was the dead god. There's not like official lore, but there is a table you can roll on that it's just this body of decomposition. And I find the idea of this just decomposing body very interesting, because of decomposition actually brings so much life with it. And there are entire ecosystems in the ocean where a dead whale falls and everything revolves around living with this dead whale, like using it for nutrients and resources and shelter and everything until it's just like bones. And I imagine something similar with this. And I think if your players are interested in things like this is a really, really great setting that comes with a lot of inspiring resources to take your brain. The left and right eyes each have a different city in it, and they kind of compete back and forth. Oculus, the city on the left eye. The larva kingdom. So different kingdoms exist throughout this, and a lot of them are tied to a specific type of insect. There's a page here to create your own city, which is really fun. So you can come up with a whole bunch of stuff of who's the leader, where do you live. There's a whole, this says on a tooth, in one eye, in the hair. But if I'm remembering correctly, there is a whole area that is just on the teeth. Like the teeth are a very important area in the dead god. The head of the dead god is the most civilized region where the largest cities and towns are located. The terrain is a landscape of hills and mountains and a vast, dense forest of hair, and the forests remain a mystery. The head has strategic advantages over other territories to resist attacks and full-scale invasion, because the only way you can reach the head is through the neck. So he talks a little bit about the interior of the dead god and how you can find places of safety. There is a radiation equivalent of something going on. So the more you traverse deeper down into this dead god, you're going to be subject to these weird energies. And they call it radiation in the book. Whether that is actual radiation or not is up to you. But there is a power that is aiding in decay, and it's causing problems to you. So to really succeed, you're going to have to get some anti-radiation equipment when you go down. The game talks about the breaches, which is an opening on the skin that has formed from something. And there are going to be like toxic substances bubbling up. There might be weird poisonous gases that have built up inside the dead god's body that are now coming out. But having a private location to delve into the interior and come back with raw materials could be very lucrative for your players. There are some negative long-term effects of radiation exposure, and then there's also some positive long-term effects of radiation exposure. There's a history of the world, of the various orders that are in it, like the Church of the Living God, the Kingdom of Larva, Guardians of the Breach. And then we get into playable species. So these are reflavored from old-school essentials. So you have things like the dwarf, the elf, the acrobat, but they are, like I said, reflavored for this. So you're going to have Mothkin, and Mothkin can fly. Their weapons are a dagger or a staff. They have no armor, and their main principle is intelligence. So a Mothkin is kind of like a wizard, so to speak, and you get various spells and stuff that work with that. You have magic. The highly sensitive Mothkins are closely connected to the magic of the dead god. You can use magical scrolls to cast spells, and you can use magical objects available to wizards. Scarafagus, which I hope I'm saying right, I believe is the warrior, where your principal characteristic is strength. You have armor and weapons any, and you're just a very strong kind of chitinous beetle, so to speak. The arachnid is going to be your thief. You're going to have dexterity, limited armor, some weapons. You're going to have a climbing skill, a bunch of other interesting aspects to rapidly run around. You have dark vision. You can create spider webs. This one was my favorite. These are bee folk, and I believe this is supposed to be the elf kind of reflavor. But I love the idea of this because you can choose strength or intelligence as your characteristic. You have hit die, armor, and stuff. You have the ability to produce honey, which can help your party members. And you also have a stinger. Now, this is a last resort attack. And if you use it, it does 3d8 points of damage. But after you use it, you have to roll a d6, and on a 1, 2, or 3, you die, and on a 4, 5, and 6, you're left with one hit point, but you can never use the attack stinger again, because as you know, when a bee stings you, they lose their stinger, and they eventually die. So this is a really interesting, you have this very strong, especially for low levels, 3d8 attack that you can use once, and never again. The Earth Knight is a worm. Their principal characteristic is dexterity. And I don't remember specifically about what their equivalent is of old school essentials, but yeah. Fungoid, I always love a good mushroom folk. And so this is the wisdom, the cleric, the funginoid. Equipment, weapons. Here's a fun tardigrade. Animals for travel and transport. Bunch of food, and then we have some of the monsters that you will encounter, like the vampire mosquito, abyssal insects, a bone child, centurion of the abyss. So lots of very, very flavored insectoid and skeletal creatures that exist within the body or on the body. A hellfly, a pus slug. Here's a hexagon area where you can use hexagon maps to kind of group out your area of the dead god. Some plots that you can generate, optional stress rules, which are really fun, a bunch of tables. And then here's a very small introductory adventure called The Horn of Goliathus Regius. Probably saying that wrong, but It's really fun. It's simple. It hits all of the flavors that you need to really emphasize this. And then what happens next is up to you. And again, the art and the map is just gorgeous. If your players needed to look at this to get a sense of what type of game they're playing, I would highly encourage you to share at least the art and the maps and stuff. It really has a fun vibe for this. So that's Settlers of a Dead God for Old School Essentials. I highly recommend it. I think it's very unique in a bunch of different things that I've read over the course of how long I've been doing YouTube. This is one of the most unique things I've ever seen. So I'll put some links down below. You can pick this up as PDF. I'll put an affiliate link for that. And then you can also pick it up in hardcover from Exalted Funeral. But I don't know for how long, because they have a habit of selling things out. So I would go fast. Thank you again, Eduardo, for sending me this copy. And I will see you guys all in the next video.